Hello everyone, so welcome you all to another wonderful video. So guys, today we are going to have an experiment with water. Okay, so guys, nothing is more flexible or softer than water. There is nothing that is more flexible or softer than water, yet it is impossible to resist water. So guys, water really has a unique property. Okay, so guys, come on. So today we are going to do a very interesting experiment. We will demonstrate buoyancy. Okay, we are going to demonstrate buoyancy. Okay, so you can see over here, these are two objects. Okay, one is a TT ball and the second one is a vessel, which I call is a boat. Okay, I'm calling it a boat. Okay, so you can see over here, both are floating. So why are they both floating? Because the mg is balanced by the buoyant force. Okay, so mg of this ball is downwards and the buoyant force is upwards. Similarly for this vessel also, mg is acting vertically downwards and buoyancy is vertically upwards. So both are relaxed position, both are balanced. Now we will make some changes. Okay, now look over here carefully. Now when I take this TT ball inside and I release it, it comes out with me. Okay, so when I take this TT ball inside and release it, it comes out. So what is happening over here, when it is going inside, the buoyant force increases more than the weight and it pushes it out. Okay, so it again starts floating on the surface. But what if we do the same thing with this vessel or the boat? So I am calling, guys, this is a behavior that is similar to a boat. Okay, so we know a boat floats in water. All right, a boat floats in water. But if this is the situation, okay, if water gets filled on the boat just sinks. It cannot come back. So guys, what happens when water fills on the boat or when water fills on the vessel? The buoyant force is not sufficient to bring it to the surface. So guys, did you get the difference between a TT ball and a boat? So guys, this was all about buoyancy. To know more, just comment. Thank you guys, and don't forget to subscribe the channel.